play last year. Their entire season was canceled due to the pandemic, so this is now just their second match really in the last 20 months. They lost their regular season opener to Santa Clara. That was on Friday. As Jackson Kessler goes down for Cal Poly, we'll play on, and here come the Gaels. Flag is up. That'll be Cal Poly's throw in coming. Cal Poly did play a couple of exhibition matches. They lost 1-0 against UCLA and then beat Fresno Pacific 4-1 before opening their regular season against Santa Clara. Arce Hurtado will try the other side for the Mustangs. St. Mary's making it very tough, not really giving up any free space, as Cal Poly struggling to maintain possession into the attacking half. That'll roll out of bounds. Throw in for the Mustangs, Emmanuel Perez. Instead, he'll drop it off for Luis Rodriguez. Here's James Person giving chase, or Riley Lynch, rather, just out of his reach. And now Person chases back, and he'll let it roll across for a goal kick. Coming up on 15 minutes here in a scoreless first half from Moraga. St. Mary's trying to win their second straight match to start the year after beating Cal in their season opener on Thursday. St. Mary's starting the year with a few home matches in a row. After this, they'll host UNLV on Friday afternoon. And then another home contest against Dixie State a week from today before their first road match, which will be at Grand Canyon. Solari pressured and now taken away by Stevens. He's battling a couple of Mustangs. Eventually, it's handled by Perez. Solari trying to evade a couple of Gaels defenders. It'll be a throw-in for the Mustangs. Cal Poly will play its home opener on Friday against San Diego State. Another freshman for these Mustangs. And we do get a whistle there, and that'll be a free kick for Cal Poly. So Glass, Solari, Bitten, and Kessler, the four freshmen in this starting unit for Cal Poly, as they set up the free kick. It's Neil Boyle who will take it, and he kind of slipped on his approach. And now St. Mary's heading the other way. And a whistle, and let's see if we get a card here. It appears we might. That was David Brogue who went down for the Gaels. Good to see him back up on his feet. He appears to be no worse for the wear. And no card coming, just a foul and a free kick for the Gaels. Three fouls against St. Mary's so far. Two whistled against Cal Poly. Or actually, that was the third now, so three aside. One corner for each team. The shot's still 4-0 in favor of St. Mary's. As that'll roll all the way through to Lapinid. Here's Engman, surveying his options, plays it for Brogue. Ahead to Vesberg. Spins his way nearly through a few different Mustangs. Couldn't quite do it, and it's Cal Poly's free kick. The shots last game for St. Mary's, 12-9 in favor of the Gaels in their match against Cal. Again, the only goal in that game coming in the 86th minute. Vesberg, the game winner. Ori Bitten takes the throw-in for Cal Poly. Jackson Kessler, another freshman from Acton, California. And now another Gale goes down. I believe that's Boyd Curry, the junior from Auckland, New Zealand. And they'll come out and take a look at him. Curry was a second-team All-WCC selection last year. He was tied for seventh in the conference in points. Finished the 3 goals and an assist, and he will head off for the moment. Looks like he's okay, and we'll certainly hope that's the case. So the clock stopped at 19:17 here in this first half. No score, Cal Poly and St. Mary's. And Curry will try to walk it off. You can see he's limping a little bit, trying to kind of stretch out that leg. And Lapinid comes forward to take the free kick for the Gaels. Left-footed boot by Lapinid. It'll be a throw-in coming for St. Mary's. And there's Curry right on cue to take it. So he appears to be all right. Gale's trying to go back to work on the attack. Vesberg has it poked away. Another throw-in. Reached the NCAA tournament again. They made it in 2019. A trip all the way to the quarterfinals back in 2011. We told you they won the conference, the WCC, in 18 and 19 as a throw-in all the way in front, and we get a whistle and it'll be the other way. But again, Coach Adam Cooper's got this program doing very well with those back-to-back conference titles, finishing in second place last year at 6-2-1 overall. And our first substitution of the afternoon, Freeman Draminu checks in for Cal Poly. Loose ball. And get a foul called against Cal Poly. See what the Gaels can put together here on the set piece. Luis DeRobo will come take it, sophomore out of Denmark. DeRobo puts it on net, punched away by Arce Hurtado. That's his third save of this first half. A little miscommunication, no harm done. Nice move by Person to free up some space. And the foul whistled against the Mustangs. 23rd minute from Moraga, no score. St. Mary's and Cal Poly, each team playing its second match of the season. Gaels trying to win their second. Timothy Stevens plays it far side for Lynch. He puts it low into the area, but it's into the area. A battle there between Kessler and Person. Person creates a little time for himself, plays for Ingman. So St. Mary's really has controlled the possession in this first half. Can they get one past Arce Hurtado? And that one came across the line. It'll be a goal kick. Shots 5-0. In favor of St. Mary's, as it looks like we've got a few more substitutions coming for Cal Poly and head coach Steve Sampson. Connor Lieber and Drew Patterson among those checking in for the first time. Told you that Jack Vesberg scored the lone goal last game for St. Mary's. David Brogue and Boyd Curry both picking up assists in that one. Chipped ahead by Cowan. Brogue gives chase, can't quite get there. Well, Boyd Curry and Sebastian Schott are the leading goal scorers returning from last season for St. Mary's. They lost Lucas Andrews, who led the team with 4 goals and 10 points a season ago. Curry and Schott both had 3 goals and an assist as they are back. Here's Vesper giving chase. Josh Graham handles it for Cal Poly. Now both go to the ground. Still a loose ball. And they'll play on as the Gaels looking for a whistle. And now Cal Poly able to clear back out to midfield. Starobo guarded by Lieber. Lapinid. Sends it 3/4 of the way down the pitch. Here's a chance for St. Mary's. Brogue. Cowan fakes the shot. Tries to get a little closer. Well defended by the Mustangs. Good idea there from Cowan. And Brogue comes and makes a good block. Andrew Forth is down for Cal Poly. Down for Cal Poly. Looks like we got a little divot there. Just out of bounds. And Forth helped back to his feet. Just over 19 minutes remaining in this first half. Alex Del Angel, the referee today. Francisco Franco and Peter Hansen are his assistants. Here come the Gaels again into the attacking half. Vesberg dropped it for Lynch. Taken away, Cal Poly, not out of danger yet. Perez weaving his way through a few defenders and now taken back by the Gaels. So again, St. Mary's making it very difficult for the Mustangs to connect on more than a couple of passes. Now Cal Poly looks to get the counterattack going, but it rolls away and it's taken by Cowan. Person for Engman. Plays it ahead for Cowan, but a little too strong. And handled by Arceo Tato. Perez giving chase. Good recovery defensively by Boyd Curry. And he sends it out of bounds. And looks like we're going to get a... both teams to hydrate a little bit. As we talked about the today at St. Mary's. So we're in the 28th minute from St. Mary's Stadium. No score between the Gaels and the Cal Poly Mustangs. The shots are 5-0 for St. Mary's. Three saves by the goalkeeper, Carlos Arce Hurtado, who has had to be sharp here in this first half. Temperature was 90 degrees when we started the match today. Now it's at 88. But still feeling very warm out there in the sun. Not a whole lot of wind either. A slight breeze. Just looking at the schedule for St. Mary's, as we told you, their next match will be on Friday right here against UNLV. That should be a bit cooler, a projected high of 79 that day. So we've talked a little bit about the goalkeeper, Carlos Arce Hurtado, for Cal Poly. Again, he's been good here in this first half. He played well in the loss against Santa Clara, made five saves, giving up just the one goal on a penalty kick. He is fourth in program history with a 1.20 goals against average. And that was coming into this season, and he's lowered it a little bit to start this year. Logan Thralls, redshirt freshman defender, into the match for Cal Poly. Steve Sampson has made quite a few substitutions here in this first half. None yet for the Gaels, as that is sent in low, and Lapine had to be alert to cover it. Lapine, the fifth year from Royal High School, Simi Valley, California. He was an all-WCC honorable mention selection last season. And as we mentioned, a good start this year. Conference Player of the Week, Defensive Player of the Week, that is, after a shutout in his first match against Cal. Curry plays it through for Brogue, but just out of his reach. This is Andrew Forth for the Mustangs. James Burkholder, another substitution into the match, and that's out of bounds. Here come the Gaels. Cowan tried to chip it ahead, but it rolls out. Boyle looking for somewhere to go with the ball. Taken away by the Gaels in a dangerous area. Stevens. Vesberg. And cleared out. Pass a little offline. Stevens couldn't quite corral it. And now giving chase the other way for Cal Poly was Patterson. That deflects well out of play in the 31st minute. So the Mustangs will get a throw-in. Connor Lieber, freshman from Phoenix, Arizona, will take it. Cal Poly still looking for their first shot of this match. Throw-in goes all the way through, and Lapine went down hard after attempting to punch it away. Let's make sure he's all right. Lapine really elevated. And we'll see if they want to bring the trainer out. Well, now good to see him get to his feet. When you land that hard, easy to get the wind knocked out of you, and so hopefully that's all that that was. Just over 14 minutes left to play in this opening half. Thanks for joining us today on the WCC Network. Ben Ross with you on the call. As Lapine boots it away for the Gaels. Drew Patterson heads it forward, but it's cleared out by Person. Mustangs will get a throw in. Again, Cal Poly picked eighth in the Big West in the preseason poll. Trying to surprise some people in that conference. The favorites, at least according to the media, UC Davis and UC Santa Barbara. They were tied for first in that preseason poll. St. Mary's picked second in the WCC preseason rankings behind LMU. Person heads it out of bounds again. Cal Poly went 7-9-1.
Wow, thank you for your time. How juicy. So with just one
opportunity put over the net, Drew Patterson with the first shot for Cal Poly, and what a look it was. Gaels dodge a bullet there, and we remain scoreless. And now we'll get our first substitutions for St. Mary's, and we get a whole host of them. We're in the 33rd minute. No score between St. Mary's and Cal Poly. Throw in coming for Boyd Curry. He had an assist in the first match of the season in the win against Cal on Thursday. We told you Curry had a strong offensive season last year, too. 3 goals in 8 games. Tied for second on the team last year with Sebastian Schott, who also returns. A little takedown there from Norman. We'll draw the whistle. Eight fouls whistled against Cal Poly today. 5 against St. Mary's. One corner aside. Just one offside so far. That one went against the Gaels. Greg Brighton just into the game for St. Mary's. Tried to create a little space. Taken now by Graham for Cal Poly. Rodriguez, he was looking for Lieber down that right sideline. Still in bounds, ping pongs between a few players, and Cowan nearly able to spring a chance for St. Mary's. Now on the far side, here comes Rotter. Pulls it back to the inside, chips it up and over the net. Pretty good look for Andrew Rotter, the sophomore from Auburn, Washington. Made a nifty play to get it back to his left foot. It sails over the goal. Let's see if the Gaels put on another little push here as we are into the final 10 minutes of this first half. They've controlled the play for most of this first half. Now a takeaway from Schott. A little too strong, though, for Brighton. Nice play by Patterson. Tried to juggle over it himself. Schott puts the pressure on, and the Gaels regain possession. St. Mary's doing a good job winning a lot of the possession battles. As Noah Bohane, another freshman into the game, out of Los Gatos High School. Cowan couldn't quite get to the loose ball. Andrew Forth the other way. And that's sent into the corner. And a goal kick coming for Arce Hurtado. Dangerous pass there. nearly trouble and now taken away by the Gaels. Cowan couldn't quite get there. And Arceo Tato falls on it. Craig Brighton with a pretty good play to set up the opportunity. Gaels. Cowan knocked down and a whistle, and Cal Poly can't believe it, but it will be a foul against the Mustangs. Thirty-ninth minute now. A scoreless first half. Throwing taken by Starobo for St. Mary's. Cowan gives it right back to him. That'll be another throw-in. So certainly plenty of international flavor on this Gaels team. Talk about Starobo from Denmark. Of course, we've talked plenty about Jack Vestberg, the freshman from Sweden. Got players from Germany, New Zealand, the Netherlands, Australia. And that'll be a throw-in coming for St. Mary's. You got Sebastian Schott from Christchurch, New Zealand as well. Free Alex Delonhel bringing over the captain Josh Graham to discuss something. It will be a free kick for Christian Engman as the Gaels put the ball back in play in the 40th minute. Starobo. Nice play to get around the oncoming Alongi. Person for Brighton. So a free kick coming for the Gaels. 5 minutes to play in the first half. Shot. Curls it high into the box, and Arceo Tato elevates to grab it. Brighton earns a throw-in for the Gaels. Got another substitution now for each team. Jaden Smoleski into the match for St. Mary's. Max Kleinhamis comes in for Cal Poly as the Gaels try to attack. Smoleski couldn't quite get there. It'll be a throw-in for Boyd Curry. And now he'll drop it off, and Christian Engman will come up to take it. Big 6'4 defender from Shoreline, Washington, a sophomore. And he will back up on the hill to get a little extra on this throw-in, try and put it right out in front. Yeah. headed away by Josh Graham. Back to Ingman. Lofts it in. Still loose in the box, Brighton. He couldn't get a good look at it. And now a whistle, and it'll go against St. Mary's, and now temper's starting to flare a little bit. But cooler heads will prevail. Both teams battling hard. We've talked about the heat today as well. Should make for an entertaining second half. Still 2.5 minutes left here in this first half. And the Gaels not done yet. Sturobo down the left side with some space. Tries to get around his defender. He gets some help from Brighton, and Brighton will earn a corner kick. Second corner today for St. Mary's. As they look to get a late one here in this first half with 2 minutes to play. Sent low in on the front side, headed out. A long went down hard there. We've seen quite a few players slip today on the pitch. That one is poked across the line, and I think that'll be another corner. And he'll send things the other way, as Arce Hurtado looked like he kind of took a little bit of a hit again. Final minute here in this first half. Shots officially are 5-1 in favor of St. Mary's. And the shots on goal are 2-0. Ready to go here in the final 30 seconds of the half. Arce Hurtado sends it out to midfield. Norman for Cal Poly sends it very high, far post. Still loose and now headed away by Bohane. Final seconds ticking away in this first half. Cal Poly trying to hustle and get one more look. And that will do it for the first half in Moraga. No score. It's Cal Poly and St. Mary's battling hard as we are scoreless through the first 45.